The Ministry of Commerce has conducted a thorough analysis of the rapid increase in food prices on the island, which impacts the issue of food security. The analysis revealed the high cost of shipping. For example, a 40-foot container from China has jumped from $3,000 US to $15,000 US within a short space of time, which negatively impacts the world supply chain. This means that irrespective of where an item is ordered, high shipping costs will have a negative effect on the eventual cost of the item. In the case of basic commodities, the government has already been subsidizing the cost of items such as sugar, flour, and rice, since the cost exceeds the current price to consumers.
I need to tell you that the Ministry of Commerce, we have responsibility for the importation of rice, flour, and sugar to this country. And I need to tell you that now the price of sugar and rice have exceeded the cost that we are retailing it to you. So right now the government of St. Lucia is cushioning the increases in the price of these basic commodities. We have not come out to the public to say so. I mean, our biggest challenge is to source it.
The statement comes as the ministry engages the private sector and civil society in discussion to ensure the ministry offers targeted assistance to all business sectors, with the focus on keeping businesses viable amid the COVID-19 crisis.
The credit unions are doing very well, but we also want to look at the non-financial cooperatives and to see how best we can turn them into viable businesses as well.
The Chamber of Commerce, Industry and Agriculture, the St. Lucia Small Business Association, the Manufacturing Association, the St. Lucia Coalition of Services, as well as the newly formed Realtors Association, which deals with real estate matters, are among some of the establishments visited by the minister. For the DBS News World, I'm Don Nicholas.